A very good morning to all the children of class 3 and welcome to your English literature class. So today, children, we will start with our new story, The Curious Baby Elephant. In the last video, we had some kind of introduction to it, but today we will start the lesson. So before we start, I would ask you something, that is, whenever we see something new, which we don't know, what we generally do, we ask, correct? We keep on asking our parents or our sister, brother, friends, relatives or anybody, like, what is that? Why he is doing like that? Why he is running? Okay, why he is laughing? What is the reason that it's raining today? So all these. So we are also curious. Similarly, in this story, this is also a story about the elephant. The baby elephant was very curious. Can you see the baby elephant? And the baby elephant was very curious. He had questions, list of questions, and it was endless. Like, they start from the beginning of the day, from the morning till night, he had questions and questions. This is a story about the origin of the elephant's long trunk. Now here is the mystery also in the story, that in the first, the elephant's trunk, that is this one, was very small and it was size of a boot. Okay, boot, the which we wear on our legs, the boot. But gradually it increased to this. So we will see in the story how it increased. Okay, so let's see what happens with the baby elephant first. So we'll do the first page of the chapter, that is page number 45. So let's begin. There was a time when the elephant's nose was no bigger than a boot. I told you already, it was the size of a boot, a shoe, you can say. He could move it from one side to the other. But an elephant's child changed all that. So who was the reason behind for this long trunk of the elephants? The baby elephant. A very curious baby elephant. What do you mean by curious? Curious means eager to know. That is, when you want to know, when you don't know anything and you keep on asking, you want to know that thing. Okay. So that is called curious. He was such a curious fellow that he always asked many questions. He would ask questions about anything he saw or heard or felt or smell. For example, if you smell something burning, will you be leaving it like that? No, you will keep on asking, what is this burning smell coming? From where it is coming? Who is there? What not? And all that. Okay, so we also keep on asking. So he would ask questions about anything he saw or heard or felt or smelled or touched. He asked the ostrich why her tail feathers grew just so, this one. He asked the giraffe what made his skin so spotty. So we know that giraffe's skin is spotty, right? So this baby elephant asked the giraffe that why the skin is spotty. We even don't know that. He asked the hippo why his eyes were red, and the baboon why melons tasted as they did. Okay, so he asked hippo why his eyes were red, because by birth hippo's eyes are red. But this curious baby elephant wanted to know that why it was red. Why the ostrich grew feathers? Why giraffe had spotty skin? So it was all about why. His parents and his uncles, that is baby elephant's parents and uncles and aunts, would spank him. What is spank? Is beat lightly. Spank him when he wouldn't stop asking questions. Beat him lightly. So when the baby elephant never stopped asking questions, the mother elephant or the uncle and aunt used to spank him or beat him lightly. So till now we will do this page today, and next in the next video we will do the later part. Before this, is it right of the baby elephant's family to have spanked him for being curious? No, I don't think so. Because when you ask me anything, do I say no, I will not tell you? No, you should not do this to anyone. If anybody is asking you, we must help them to know what they are asking. Is curiosity a bad thing? No, it's not a bad thing. We all learn from the new things. So knowing things is very necessary. Okay. So why or why not? I already explained. Now what happens to this baby elephant? We will see in the next video. Before that, I promised you in the last video that I'll give you the answers. So here are the answers. An elephant's trunk. Elephant has got a long trunk. A zebra got stripes. Turtle has got a shell. So everybody, a turtle got a shell. I did not give this answer yesterday. Today I'm giving you. So if it is correct, put a star beside. If it is not, cross and write the correct answer. Okay. A leopard has got spots. See, spots on the body. It was there in the picture only yesterday. But I did not tell you. I wanted you to write it yourself. Okay. A fish has got fins and scales. Okay. I hope you all are writing down in your book. Page number 44. Number 6. A deer has got antelope. See, antelope. These are the horns. Antelopes are the horns. I told you to get the spelling. So here is the right spelling. You can check it. That is antilope. Okay. Number 7. A bear has fur. F-U-R, fur. Okay. So this is the answer I gave you. Now you will read the page number 45. And again, we'll come back in the next video. Okay. Take care, everyone.